Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvenni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the solution and discussion on gate question paper in Mechanical Engineering subject. And this is lecture number 21 and we are going to discuss the questions from steam boiler and steam nozzle. There are only few questions asked in the gate examination on this topic, and the books I have published earlier, Design of Transmission System, Turbo Machines, Heat and Mass Transfer, Operations Research, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion, Thermal Engineering, Fluid Mechanics and Machinery. Also, I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures of all the subjects mentioned here, and the video lectures on the solution for gate question paper is also uploaded in the YouTube channel. You please subscribe the YouTube channel and use the videos for your better learning and to pass in the gate examination, and it is absolutely free of cost. And the first question is from 1992 question paper. Boiler rating is usually defined in terms of, so boiler rating, what are the terminology for boiler rating from the four options given? Option A, maximum temperature of the steam in Kelvin, heat transfer rate in kilojoules per hour, heat transfer area in meter square, steam output in kilogram per hour. So among the four options, the correct answer is steam output in kilograms per hour. So the quantity of steam produced in kilograms per hour, that is the boiler rating parameter. The next question is from 1989 question paper. The fundamental objective of employing condenser in a steam power plant is to reduce or increase the dash of the steam. So it is the fundamental objective of employing condenser in the steam power plant is to reduce the pressure of the steam in the power plant. Which among the following is the boiler mounting? So this is the question from 1997 question paper. The four options are blow off cock, feed pump, economizer and superheater. The correct answer is blow off cock. So without the boiler mounting, so the mounting is a device which is installed in the boiler for the safety and operation of the boiler. And whereas the other items mentioned in the list, feed pump, economizer and the superheater, they are called as accessories. They are installed in the boiler to improve the efficiency of the boiler. So the mounting among the four is the blow off cock. The next question is from 1989 question paper. An economizer in the steam generator performs the function of, for four options given, preheating the combustion air, preheating the feed water, preheating the input fuel and raising this temperature of the steam. So the correct option is preheating the feed water. Economizer is used for heating the feed water, air preheater is used for preheating the combustion air, and superheater is used for raising the temperature of the steam. So the correct option is B, preheating the feed water, that is the function of the economizer. Next question is from 1993 question paper. The equivalent evaporation in kilograms per hour of a boiler producing 2000 kg per hour of steam with the enthalpy content of 2426 kilojoules per kilogram from feed water at a temperature of 40 degrees Celsius, and the liquid enthalpy is 168 kilojoules per kilogram. The enthalpy of vaporization of water at 100 degrees Celsius is 2258 kilojoules per kilogram. There are four options given, equivalent evaporation 2000, 2149, 1682 and 1649. So we calculate the equivalent evaporation. So equivalent evaporation equal to M into H minus H of 1 divided by 2258. So M is the value given, 2000 kilograms per hour. H value, enthalpy of the steam is given as 2426 minus H of 1 is the enthalpy of feed water, which is given as 168 divided by 2258 is the enthalpy for enthalpy of evaporation at 100 degrees Celsius. So calculating, it is 2000. Equivalent evaporation is 2000. So the answer is 2000 kilogram per hour. The next question is from 1996 question paper. A steam power plant has the boiler efficiency 92%, turbine efficiency, mechanical efficiency of turbine 94%, generator efficiency 95% and cycle efficiency 44%. If 6% of generator power is used to run the auxiliaries, the overall plant efficiency. There are four options given: 34%, 39%, 45%, and 30%. And we have to calculate overall efficiency equal to boiler efficiency into turbine efficiency into generator efficiency into the cycle efficiency into 1 minus auxiliary efficiency. The power we used to for running the accessories or auxiliary units. So, 0.92 into 0.94 into 0.95 into 0.44 into 1 minus 0.06 equal to 0.34. The answer is 34%. So, the overall efficiency of the plant is 34%. The next question from steam nozzle. If Vn and alpha are the nozzle exit velocity and nozzle angle in an impulse turbine, the optimum blade velocity is given by Vn sin alpha, Vn sin 2 alpha, Vn cos alpha by 2, Vn sin alpha by 2. So, the optimum blade speed ratio sigma equal to Vb by Vn equal to cos alpha by 2. And Vb, the blade speed, optimum blade speed equal to Vn cos alpha divided by 2. So, the correct option is option C, Vn cos alpha divided by 2. The next question is from 1992 question paper. Subsonic and supersonic diffusers have the following geometry: divergent and convergent respectively, both divergent, both convergent and divergent respectively. So, these are all the geometries. The subsonic and supersonic diffuser. So, diffuser is the device which is increasing the pressure and decreasing the velocity. Whatever may be the condition, whether it be subsonic condition or the supersonic condition, diffuser is the device which is increasing the pressure and decreasing the velocity. The first diagram is the subsonic diffuser. So, Mach number is less than 1 is subsonic, Mach number is greater than 1 is supersonic. This is subsonic diffuser, where the pressure is increasing, velocity is decreasing. This is supersonic diffuser, which is where again pressure is increasing, velocity is decreasing. So, this passage is called as diverging passage and this passage is called as converging passage. So, the correct option is divergent and convergent respectively. So, subsonic and supersonic diffuser have the following geometry. So, subsonic diffuser will have the divergent passage. Supersonic diffuser will have the convergent passage. The next question is from 1990 question paper. When initially dry and saturated steam flows through a nozzle, the ratio of actual discharge to the calculated discharge is equal to 1, greater than 1, less than 1, independent of the inlet condition. So, we have to calculate actual mass flow rate of the steam divided by calculated mass flow rate of the steam. So, mass flow rate is A2 V2 by V2 at the discharge. So, A2 is the area, V2 is the velocity, small V2 is the specific volume. So, A2 area geometry, there is no change. But the two parameters are changing, velocity and the small V2. For super saturated flow, for initially dry saturated, due to the super saturation, the super saturation increases the entropy and decreases and specific volume of the steam. So, specific volume increases and entropy is also increasing. The supersaturation increases the dryness fraction of the steam. The supersaturation reduces the heat drop below that for the thermal equilibrium, which causes the decrease in the exit velocity. So, exit velocity is decreasing, specific volume is increasing. So, both the cases, V2 is decreasing, small V2 is increasing. So, both will reduce the mass. So, the calculated mass is less than the actual mass. So, the value is greater than 1. So, ratio of actual mass to the calculated mass is greater than 1 because of the supersaturated flow. The next question is, match the following. We have two lists. We have to match steam nozzle, compressible flow, surface tension, heat conduction. On the other side, we have the Mach number, reaction turbine, Biot number, Nusselt number, supersaturation and the Weber number. So, based on the theoretical knowledge, steam nozzle is connected with the supersaturated flow. Compressible flow is connected with the Mach number. Surface tension is connected with the Weber number. Heat conduction is connected with the Biot number. So, the Nusselt number, the reaction turbine, they are left out in the right hand side, list 2. The next question is from 1998 question paper. The isentropic enthalpy drop in a nozzle of an impulse turbine with a nozzle efficiency of 0.9, blade velocity ratio of 0.5 and mean blade velocity is 150 meters per second in kilojoules per kilogram is 50, 40, 60 and 75. You have to calculate isentropic enthalpy drop of a nozzle for the given problem. So, we are given VB by V. Blade speed ratio VB by V equal to 0.5. So, VB equal to 150 because V is given as mean blade velocity is 150. So, VB is given as 150. So, VB by V equal to 0.5. We calculate V equal to VB by 0.5 equal to 150.5 equal to 300 meters per second. Then we calculate nozzle efficiency equal to V square by 2 into delta H. That is what the definition of nozzle efficiency. So, we have to calculate delta H, enthalpy difference, enthalpy drop in the nozzle. So, delta H equal to V square by 2 into eta n. So, 300 square divided by 2 into 0.9 equal to 50,000 joules per kilogram or 50 kilojoules per kilogram. So, the answer is 50 kilojoules per kilogram. That is the answer. That is the enthalpy drop, isentropic enthalpy drop in the nozzle. The next question is from 2000 question paper. For a compressible fluid, sonic velocity, there are four options. Sonic velocity is a property of fluid, always given by square root of gamma RT, where gamma R and T are respectively ratio of specific heats, gas constant, temperature in Kelvin, always given by dou P by dou rho at constant entropy to the power 0.5, where P, rho and S are respectively pressure, density and entropy. Always greater than velocity of the fluid at any given location. So, here the answer is option B and C. Both are correct for compressible fluid sonic velocity. So, both give the sonic velocity, right? So, always given by gamma RT and always given by square root of dou P by dou rho at constant entropy. So, we stop here. There are only few questions in the steam boiler and the steam turbine. So, we stop here and thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box in the YouTube video. You subscribe the channel so that you will get the intimation regarding the updated videos. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification. Thank you for watching once again and we will meet again in another video from other question paper from the GATE questions.